Will oak galls kill my tree? And what causes them? And Peter, we just so happen to have a certified arborist with us today. So yes. Wes, yes. I know you get this question a lot because we get at the office about the oak galls.
Yeah, and this year has been the worst year of my entire career that I've seen the gall. The
entire career. Wow, okay.
The gouty oak gall in particular. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Up north, as in my travels through Illinois, I noticed that there was some fatalities with the trees directly related to the gall.
Okay.
So I had to say, yes, it's going to be a problem. And they're primarily in the cherry bark oaks, which is the most common oak tree that we have in the Mid-South here.
Now, what causes the galls, though?
The galls are caused from the egg-laying of the centipede wasp.
So it's a wasp.
It's a tiny wasp. It's about the size of the end of an ink pen. It's when the insect lays its egg into the twig of the tree, mm-hmm. It causes the damage in the pheromones with the egg injection causes the tree to respond and develop new growth, therefore causing the gall to form.
Okay, I got it.
And it's actually a container for the eggs to grow.
Okay.
So it's like a shell in a sense.
Actually makes sense, okay.
Yeah, I have a sample. And
you actually have some, yeah, we can look at, okay.
Yeah, this would be your gouty oak gall. And as you can see, it's large, it's heavy. And in the past, it's more of an aesthetic problem. Of course, you don't want these to fall out of the tree and conk you in the head.
Right.
But there's about 50 different species in the United States that causes this particular gall. However, with the centipede wasp, there's actually about 700 different species, mm-hmm. that are gall makers. But for this particular type gall is about
so there's nothing that you can really do about the wasp, right?
Not in my opinion.
Okay.
Nothing that's really effective.
Effective, right, okay.
Because this insect doesn't feed on the tree.
Okay.
It's only uses the tree for the egg laying.
Right.
And the inside this gall right here, this gall will hold the larvae and the adult for up to 2 years.
Wow.
And so when they leave this is where the problem comes in. When they leave this stage, they can cause another type of gall, like the apple gall. And it's a strange process. It takes a lot of reading to understand this particular insect. It's very complex. And then when they hatch from this stage right here, which they could be in this form for 2 years, they could be in this form for maybe 3 to 6 months. Jeez. And then when they leave that stage, they can cause another type of gall.
Oh my goodness.
The marble gall. Now the problem that we're having with this gall is the population of this insect, and you can see some damage right here from the egg laying, from the ovipositor, but I have another sample here.
And I've seen that before.
Yeah.
I have.
This is actually a crepe myrtle, and this is actually cicada damage, mm-hmm. but the damage is the same. And you can see where that egg laying, now the ovipositor, I'll explain, is like a hypodermic needle. Mm-hmm. And it goes under the bark and it injects the egg into the tree.
Hmm. Interesting.
And these eggs fertilize themselves. They don't. Okay. It doesn't take, you know, male and female to cause eggs to grow.
Wow.
But you can see this stem was killed from the cicada damage. And if you notice with our cherry bark oaks, we're seeing a real thin canopy this year and a lot of tip dieback. And it's because the population of the centipede wasp is causing the twigs. The damage to the vascular tissue of the tree.
How about that?
It's pretty severe. I don't know what we're going to do about it.
But you did say they were beneficial.
They're beneficial in the fact that they're a predatory insect and but this is, they're not totally beneficial.
Not totally beneficial.
Yeah, for the sake of our cherry bark trees, they may affect the population, but you know, it's like everything in nature, it's going to run its course.
Sure.
And maybe in the next 2 years, it won't be such a problem.
Wow. I'm glad you brought those. That's a good example.
Actually, I found them on your property right here. But I can find them on anybody's property.
Yeah, anywhere.
Anybody that has a cherry bark oak. It's not the only oak that they affect. They affect all oak trees.
All oak trees.
It's just primarily in this area, it's the the cherry bark oak.
Okay.
I'm seeing it on willow, I'm seeing it on water, southern red. Not southern red. That's the only one that I haven't seen it on. But yeah, there's other oaks that it is.
All right, Wes, we appreciate that. That was good.